Hey guys, right, so this is me now going to show you how these fans have held up in the last month. So I've got to take them out and take them out my AIO like this. For you ask, the screwdriver set I am using is from E-Technics. It's not bad toolkit, especially for 20 quid, not bad at all. Right, so this is how the fans have held up. Now, as you can see, look, there's little to no dust. They have held up quite well. The fins are actually really strong. There's no chips, there's no marks. As you can see, the dust, but there. Let me just zoom in and show you. But look, that's not bad for a month. And considering how clean the fans are themselves, which is very, very surprising. But what do you expect? You get quality fans for the price. They're very, very robust, strong fans. And my cooling is not bad at all. Now, my previous fans were literally stuck at 1300 RPM. They were the Fantex fans. You can go check that video out if I remember to place it here in the video. But for the price, which were £45, it isn't bad because you get a daisy chained ARGB thing, see? You get a male and a female with this little cover bit here, so you can daisy chain more than one. At the moment, I've only got two. I'm trying to get the 120 variant, but they don't sell them in a pack of three. They only sell the sparkle versions, but I'm not paying for that when they are 12 volt and not 5 volt like these. But for a 5-pack of these in a 120 millimeter version, it is £60. I don't think they're worth that type of money, but because they don't do these fans individually selling them, not even on the Amazon, not even on the Antec website, I'm gonna have to buy another pack of these 2 packs for £45 just so I can have two in the front, because at the moment I've got my GIM fans. Sorry, I'm just adjusting, but yeah, the GIM fans. These fans have actually held up quite well. I mean, the fins are very robust. There's literally little to no dust on them after a full month of use. That just goes to show how a good airflow my case is and how much the positive air pressure in my case is quite good. I've got two 120s at the front, one 120 at the back, which is the GIM white fans. I've already done a review on them. Check it out on my channel. I've done a full review on the Antec fans, which these fans at the full 1600 RPM are very, very loud. Very. The only problem I've had, really, is the sound. It went, because these are levitated off my AIO like that. This by here, the bearing inside, is a lubricated bearing, which they're supposed to be good for this, but for some reason I get a little play inside the fan, so it makes like a clicking type noise. So my recommendation is, if you're looking for 120s or 120s, the GIM fans are amazing value at £20, but for the price of these are very well made, very quality based fans for the price. Yes, £45 a lot of money to some people, but for an AIO, so you could have full RGB control from one fan. Now, these are PWM, so you can control these either in your BIOS or they're in the MSI Dragon Center, which these are currently linked into because they're linked into the motherboard by a header. I can do the RPMs there, but that's the problem with the GIM fans, is they don't. The only thing you can adjust on the GIM fans really is the the RGB aspect of it because they're not PWM, so they're only a 3-pin. But yeah, for these, now these, for these fans themselves, for a month of use, there is literally no blemishes, no problems, nothing whatsoever. And these LEDs at the top, now you get two rings, which are one there and one there. These rings, the best RGB mode I've had with these are the actual mosaics, where they do like a little pattern. They go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And these are very, very bright fans. They are actually a lot better in colour compared to the GIM fan. But with all it together, they're amazing fans. So these fans have held up amazingly for over a month of use. Now, I will do another video of this in the next 6 months, next 3 to 4 months now, to make sure that longevity is what you were looking for. Now, this is why I bought premium fans, for the longevity, because the Fantex ones I had were originally with the Fantex Enthrolux, but they were over. Well, I bought this case in 2014, so, you know, it's a long time, and the fans started making noises, and also they started seizing because the lubrication in the bearing started drying up, which they do over time. The same with any of these type bearings, unless you've got a magnet type bearing that doesn't require a lubrication. It just makes the fan spin with a magnetic inside that has like a coil, and then it just spins by itself. Now, these are just a lubricated type bearing, so they've got little tiny little balls at the ends in a copper wire, which they need lubrication to actually spin. These GIM fans, even though these are the cheap type bearings, these have had about 3 weeks now, and these are actually quite brilliant. But yeah, anyway, sorry, just me spitballing, it is. But yeah, these fans have definitely held up in the last month. I would definitely recommend them. If you want the link, I will leave a link in the description. It also helps out the channel. So yeah, that's my point of view on them. They've held up for a month. They're brilliant quality. Just go buy them. I hope you enjoyed the video. It's a little bit of a mix, but this is kind of my style. I don't do scripts, I don't do points, I just go off the fly with my head, because I believe that's the best unique way of doing it. So yeah, this is Richard from WELSHYTECH. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button down below. Also check us out at welshy.co.uk, our own personal website. Not long has it been launched, so yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Goodbye.